अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस पर विश्व भर के योग प्रेमियों को अनेक अनेक शुभकामनाएं। इस शताब्दी में हम अनुभव कर रहे हैं, योग ने पूरे विश्व को जोड़ दिया है। जैसे योग शरीर, मन, बुद्धि, आत्मा को जोड़ता है, वैसे आज योग विश्व को भी जोड़ रहा है। हर कोई चाहता है तनाव मुक्त जीवन हो, पीड़ा मुक्त जीवन हो, बीमारी से मुक्त जीवन हो, प्रसन्न जीवन हो। इन सबको अगर किसी एक मार्ग से पाया जा सकता है तो वो मार्ग है योग का। एक संपूर्ण जीवन को संतुलित रूप में कैसे जिया जा सकता है, तन से, मन से, विचारों से, आचारों से स्वस्थता की अंतर यात्रा कैसे चले, वो अगर अनुभव करना है तो योग के माध्यम से अनुभव हो सकता है। आज विश्व का हर नागरिक जीवन शैली के कारण, कार्य की शैली के कारण, आपाधापी के कारण, बढ़ती हुई जिम्मेवारियों के कारण तनाव से मुक्त जीवन जीना मुश्किल होता जा रहा है। तब हमें हमारी दिनचर्या में, हमारे जीवन में, हमारे कार्यकलाप में उन चीजों को लाना बहुत आवश्यक है जो हमें तनाव भरी अवस्था में भी तनाव से मुक्त रहने का रास्ता दिखाए, ताकत दे, और वो संभव है योग के नित्य अभ्यास से। मैं सभी योग प्रेमियों से आग्रह करूंगा कि हर वर्ष हम संकल्प करें कितने नए योग अभ्यासियों को हम साल भर में जोड़ेंगे। योग को एक आंदोलन बनाने में हम स्वयं क्या भूमिका निभाएंगे। और आप देखिए, दुनिया की सुख शांति में हम योग के द्वारा अहम योगदान दे सकते हैं। मैं आपको निमंत्रित करता हूं, सिर्फ अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योगा दिवस नहीं, लेकिन योग जन चेतना जगाने के लिए, जन मन को स्वस्थ बनाने के लिए एक आंदोलन बने और आप उस आंदोलन के योगी बने, यही मेरी आप सबको बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं हैं।
योग भारत की सांस्कृतिक विरासत है। आज योग पूरे विश्व में फैल रहा है और इसके विस्तार के पीछे अनेक योग गुरुओं का योगदान रहा है। योग के द्वारा पूरे विश्व में लोग आरोग्यवर्धक और रोग निदान का लाभ उठा रहे हैं। विश्व योग दिवस के सफल आयोजन हेतु मेरी शुभकामनाएं।
Inhale serenity, exhale stress, reach out to flexibility, leave behind chronic pains, shut out the world, tune in to your inner being, work out for your mind, body and spiritual well-being. Add yoga to your life, add life to your lifestyle. While addressing the 69th session of United Nations General Assembly on September 27, 2014, the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi, had urged the world community to adopt an International Day of Yoga with these words.
Yoga hamari purantan paramparik amulya den hai. Yoga man va sharir vichar व कर्म संयम व उपलब्धि की एकात्मता का तथा मानव व प्रकृति के बीच सामंजस्य का मूर्त रूप है। यह स्वास्थ्य व कल्याण का समग्र दृष्टिकोण है। योग केवल व्यायाम भर न होकर अपने आप से तथा विश्व व प्रकृति के साथ तादात्म्य को प्राप्त करने का माध्यम है। यह हमारी जीवन शैली में परिवर्तन लाकर तथा हम में जागरूकता उत्पन्न करके जलवायु परिवर्तन से लड़ने में सहायक हो सकता है। आइए हम एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस को आरंभ करने की दिशा में कार्य करें।
ड्यू टू हिज गवर्नमेंट्स कंसर्टेड एफर्ट्स 21st June was established as International Day of Yoga in 2014. With a record consensus of 177 co-sponsoring countries in the 193-member UNGA. In its resolution, the UNGA recognized that yoga provides a holistic approach to health and well-being, while bringing harmony in all walks of life. It was there that the need for wider dissemination of information about the benefits of practicing yoga for the health of world population was felt. In India, it ushered in an era of holistic health revolution based on the principles of prevention more than the cure. The Ministry of Ayush successfully organized the first International Day of Yoga on the 21st June 2015 at Rajpath, where two Guinness World Records were made. One for the largest yoga lesson, involving 35,985 participants, and the other for maximum number of nationalities, with participants from 84 countries, in a single yoga lesson. Ever since, the International Day of Yoga celebrations have grown in size and stature all over the world, with new enthusiasts taking up in this ancient form of well-being year by year. Yoga is essentially a spiritual discipline based on an extremely subtle science, which focuses on bringing harmony between mind and body. Yoga is a practice that combines art with science to give us a roadmap for healthy living. According to its Sanskrit root, yuj, the word yoga means to join or to unite. And the practice of yoga is said to lead to the union of an individual consciousness with the universal consciousness. Yoga is widely considered as an immortal cultural outcome of the Indus-Saraswati Valley civilization, dating back to 2700 BC. Even though yoga was practiced during the pre-Vedic period, it was Maharishi Patanjali who systematized and codified the practices through his Yoga Sutras. For his invaluable contribution to the system, he is known as Father of Classic Yoga. Later, many masters contributed to the preservation and development of yoga by documenting the practices and spreading them all over the world. Today, millions of people across the globe are benefiting from the practice of yoga. Medical research in recent years has shown many physical and mental benefits of regular yoga practice. Yoga works on the levels of one's body, energy, mind, and emotion. This has led to the identification of four broad classifications of yoga. Jnana Yoga, the yoga of wisdom. Bhakti Yoga, which utilizes the emotion. Karma Yoga, which utilizes the body, and Kriya Yoga, which utilizes the energy. Each system of yoga we practice falls within these categories. These have further been adopted and developed by different schools of yoga, namely Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga, Patanjala Yoga, Hatha Yoga, Kundalini Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, Mantra Yoga, Laya Yoga, Raja Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Bodha Yoga, etc. Some of the widely practiced yoga sadhanas are Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi, Bandha, Mudra, Shatkarma, Yuktahara, Mantra Jap, Yukta Karma. A yoga practitioner should follow the guiding principles of yogic practices. Before practice, yogic practices should be performed in a calm and quiet atmosphere, with relaxed body and mind. It should be done on an empty stomach or light stomach. Consume a small amount of honey in lukewarm water if you feel weak. Light and comfortable cotton clothes are preferred to facilitate easy movements of the body. In case of chronic diseases or pains or cardiac problems, a physician or a yoga therapist should be consulted prior to performing yogic practices. During practices, practice sessions should start with a prayer or invocation, as it creates a conducive environment to relax the mind. Yogic practices should be performed slowly in a relaxed manner, with awareness of the body and breath. Do not hold the body tightly or jerk the body. Perform the practices according to your own capacity. End the session with deep silence or shanti path. Food and bath may be taken only 20 to 30 minutes after the practice. Once prepared, step into the world of yoga with mindfulness and avail the benefits of this centuries-old wisdom. Let us enter into the world of yoga.
Sangachadvam samvadadvam
Sangachadvam samvadadvam
Samvo manamsi janata
Samvo manamsi janata
Deva bhagam yatha purve
Deva bhagam yatha purve
Sanyanana upasate
Sanyanana upasate
Sanyanana upasate
Sanyanana upasate
Sanyanana upasate
Sanyanana upasate
Let us start yog sadhana with yogic sukshma vyayam or loosening practices to increase microcirculation. Neck movements. Forward and backward neck bending. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of severe cervical spondylitis. Start with alert posture. Samasthiti. Stand with the feet 2 to 3 inches apart. Keep the hands on the waist. While exhaling, move the head forward slowly and try to touch the chest with the chin. While inhaling, move the head backwards in a comfortable way. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Right and left neck bending. Caution, do not overstrain during practice. While exhaling, bend the head slowly to the right. Experience stretching on the left side. While inhaling, bring the head to the center position. While exhaling, bend the head to the left side. Experience stretching on the right side. Inhale and bring the head to the center position. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Right and left neck twisting. Caution, do not give jerk to the neck. Keep the head straight. While exhaling, gently turn the head to the right so that the chin is in line with the shoulder. While inhaling, bring the head to the center position. While exhaling, turn the head to the left. Feel or experience stretching on the right side. Inhale and bring the head to the center position. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Neck rotation. Caution. People with neck pain and cervical spondylosis do this practice carefully. Exhale. Bend the head forward, trying to touch the chest with the chin. Inhale. Slowly rotate the head clockwise in a circular motion. Exhale while coming down. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Then, rotate the head in an anti-clockwise direction. Inhale, go back, exhale, and come down. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Relax. Shoulder movements. Shoulders and arms movement. Caution. Frozen shoulder patients do this practice carefully. Start with alert posture. Samasthiti. Keep the fingers together, pointing downwards. While inhaling, move both the arms from side above the head with the palm facing outward. Exhale and bring them down. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Shoulder rotation. Stand straight. Inhale and raise both the arms up to shoulder level and bend them in from the elbows. Place the fingers on the respective shoulders. Try to touch the elbows in front of the chest. Rotate both the elbows and shoulders in a circular manner. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Do the same in reverse manner two times. Inhale while raising the arms and exhale while bringing them down. Bring the arms down and relax. Trunk movement. Trunk twisting. Caution. In case of vertebral disorders, do this practice under the guidance. Starting from the alert posture, raise both the arms up to the chest level, keeping the palms facing each other and the arms parallel to each other. Keep the feet about 1 foot apart. While exhaling, twist the body towards the right side. Come back with inhalation. While exhaling, rotate the trunk and spine towards the left side. Come back with inhalation. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Slowly return the arms with exhalation and feet together. Relax. Knee movement. Caution. In case of arthritis and obesity, do this practice carefully. Start in alert posture. Then keep the feet 1 foot apart. Inhale. Move your arms up to the shoulder level from the front, palms facing downwards. Exhale, bend the knees and bring down your body to the half squatting position. In the final position, both the arms and thighs should remain parallel to the ground. Come back with inhalation. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Slowly return the arms with exhalation and bring the feet together. Relax. Now, let us move towards Yogasana. Standing postures. Tadasana or the palm tree posture. Caution. Avoid lifting the heels in case of arthritis, varicose veins and vertigo. Starting from alert posture, assume standing position. Keep your feet 2 inches apart. Inhale. Lift your arms up to the shoulder level from the front. Interlock the fingers. Exhale. Turn the palms outward. Now, inhale. Stretch the arms over your head. Raise the heels off the floor and balance on the toes. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Bring the heels down. Release the interlock of the fingers. Exhale. Bring the arms down by the sides and come back to starting posture. Vrikshasana or the tree posture. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of arthritis, vertigo and obesity. Starting from alert posture, Focus on a point in front. Exhale. Move the right leg up and place the foot on the inner side of the left thigh. The heel should be touching the perineum. Inhale and extend the arms up and join the palms together in Namaskar Mudra. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Bring the arms down. Release the right leg and bring it to the starting position. Repeat on the other side. Exhale. Move the left leg up and place the foot on the inner side of the right thigh. The heel should be touching the perineum. Inhale and extend the arms up and join the palms together in Namaskar Mudra. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Bring the arms down. Release the left leg and bring it to the starting position. Padhastasana or the hands to the feet posture. Caution. Please avoid this practice in case of cardiac spinal disorders and glaucoma. From the starting posture, assume standing position with feet 2 inches apart. Inhale slowly and raise the arms upwards from the front. Stretch up the body from the waist. Exhale and bend forward at the level of hip joints until both the palms rest fully on the ground. Stretch the back to make it as straight as possible. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Now inhale. Come up slowly to the upright position and stretch the arms above the head. Exhale. Slowly bring down the arms and return to the starting position. Ardha Chakrasana or the half wheel posture. Caution. Avoid this posture in case of vertigo and in cardiac problems. Starting from alert posture, stand with feet 2 inches apart. Support the back at the sides of the waist with the fingers. Try to keep the elbows parallel to each other. Drop the head backwards, stretching the front side of the neck. As you exhale, bend backwards from the lumbar region. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale and slowly come up and return to the starting position. Relax. Trikonasana or the triangle posture. Caution. Avoid this posture in case of slipped disc, sciatica, and after abdominal surgery. From the alert posture, spread out the feet 3 feet apart. Inhale. Raise both the arms from the side up to the shoulder level and palms facing outwards. Turn the right foot towards right side. Exhale. Slowly bend to the right side and place the right hand just behind the right foot. The left arm is straight in line with the right arm. Turn your head and gaze at the tip of the left middle finger. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale. Slowly come up and bring the right foot back. Repeat on the other side. Turn the left foot towards left side. exhale. Slowly bend to the left side and place the left hand just behind the left foot. Turn your head and gaze at the tip of the right middle finger. The right arm is straight in line of the left arm. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale. Slowly come up. And bring the left foot back. Exhale. Bring the arms down and feet together. Come to the starting position and relax. Sitting postures. Bhadrasana or the firm posture. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of severe arthritis and sciatica. Start with Vishramasana. Support the back with the hands. Both legs stretched forward. Body should be relaxed in long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Keep the hands beside the hips and palms resting on the floor. Now, bring the soles of your feet together. Exhale and clasp the toes with the hands. Inhale. Put your heels as close as possible up to the perineum region. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Release the hands and stretch out the legs in the front. Relax. Vajrasana or diamond posture. Caution. Those who are suffering from knee pain and ankle injury should avoid this practice. Start with long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Palms resting on the ground. Fingers pointing forward. Fold the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the right buttock. Similarly, folding the left leg, place left foot under the left buttock. Place both the feet in such a way so that the big toes touch each other. Position of the buttocks is in the space between the heels and feet. Keep hands on respective knees. Keep the back straight. Gaze in front or close the eyes. When returning to the starting position, bend a little towards right side to take out your left leg and extend it. Similarly, extend your right leg and return to the starting position. Ardh Ushtrasana or half camel posture. Caution. In case of hernia, abdominal injuries, arthritis and vertigo, please avoid doing this asana. Start with long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Palm resting on the ground, fingers pointing forward. Fold the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the right buttock. Similarly, folding the left leg, place left foot under the left buttock. Kneel up with thighs vertical. Place the hands over the buttocks with fingers pointing downward. Keep the upper arms in line. Inhale, bend the head back and stretch the neck. Exhale, bend the trunk backwards as much as possible. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale, come back to kneeling position. Stretch out the legs, return to starting position. relax. Ushtrasan or camel posture. Caution: those suffering from hernia should not practice this asana. Start with long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Palms resting on the ground. Fingers pointing forward. Fold the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the right buttock. Similarly, folding the left leg, place left foot under the left buttock. Kneel up with thighs vertical. Place the knees and the feet about few inches apart. While inhaling, bend backward without jerking the neck. Place the right palm on right heel and left palm on left heel and exhale. Weight of the body should be evenly supported by the arms and legs. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale, come back and kneel down. Stretch out the legs. Return to starting position and relax. Shashakasana or the hare posture. Caution: avoid this posture in case of osteoarthritis of the knees. Start with long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Palms resting on the ground. Fingers pointing forward. Fold the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the right buttock. Similarly, folding the left leg, place left foot under the left buttock. Spread both the knees wide apart, keeping the big toe touching each other. Place the palms between the knees. Exhale, bend forward with arms outstretched and place the chin on the ground. Keep the arms parallel. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale and come up and close the knees together. Stretch the legs. Return to starting position. Relax. Uttan Mandukasana or the stretched up frog posture. Caution: patients with osteoarthritis of the knees should avoid kneeling down position. Start with long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Palms resting on the ground. Fingers pointing forward. Fold the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the right buttock. Similarly, folding the left leg, place left foot under the left buttock. Keep the palms between the knees. Spread the knees wide apart. Raise both your arms, fold them from the elbow and place the palms on alternate shoulder blades, that is, right palm on left shoulder blade and left palm on right shoulder blade. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Now, inhale and raise the arms up. Exhale, bring the arms down and close the knees together. Stretch the legs and return to starting position. Relax. Vakrasan or the seated twist posture. Caution: avoid this posture in case of acute back pain and spinal disorders. Start with long sitting posture. Sit with the back straight with the legs stretched out in the front. Bend the right leg and place the foot beside the left knee. Bring the left arm around the right knee and place the palm beside the right foot. Exhale. Turn your body and head to the right. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths. Inhale and come back. We will now repeat the same on the left side. Bend the left leg. Place the left foot beside the right knee. Bring the right arm around the left knee and place the palm beside the left foot. Exhale and twist your head and body to the left. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths. Inhale, come back. Relax. Prone postures. Makarasan or the crocodile posture. Caution: avoid this practice in case of pregnancy and frozen shoulder. To start, slowly lie down on your stomach with feet together and toes pointing outwards. Put the chin on the hands. Open the feet apart with toes pointing sideways. Head up and place to the right on your hands. Keep the eyes closed and relax the whole body. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Remain aware of the body and breathing. Bhujangasan or the cobra posture. Caution: those suffering from hernia and stomach ulcers should not practice this asana. Start with Makarasana. Now, join the legs and place your palms beside the chest and elbows close to the body. Inhale. Slowly lift the head and chest up to the navel region with the help of spinal muscles. Keep the elbows parallel and maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Bring the head down and rest your chin on the ground. Bend both the arms. Put the chin on the hands. With the feet wide apart, toes pointing outward. Head up and place to the right on your hands. Relax. Shalabhasana or the locust posture. Caution: those with severe lower back pain, peptic ulcer, hernia and cardiac patients should avoid this posture. Start with Makarasana. Now, join the legs. Place both hands beside the body, palms facing downwards. Inhale and lift both the legs off the floor without bending the knees. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths. Exhale and bring the legs down to the floor. Bend both the arms. Put the chin on the hands. With the feet wide apart, toes pointing outward. Head up and place to the right on your hands. Relax. Supine postures. Setu Bandhasana or the bridge posture. Caution: those suffering from stomach ulcers and hernia should not practice this asana. In this asana, you start in a supine position by bending both the legs at the knees and bringing the heels near the buttocks. While holding both the ankles as per your convenience, keep the knees and feet in one straight line. Inhale. Slowly raise your buttocks and trunk up as much as you can to form a bridge. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Slowly bring your hips down and straighten the legs in supine position. Relax. Uttan Padasana or the raised leg position. Caution. People with hypertension should practice this asana with one leg, alternatively. Lie comfortably on the ground, hands placed by the sides and palms facing down. While inhaling, slowly raise both the legs without bending them at the knees until you are able to see the tips of toes. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Slowly bring both the legs down and place them on the ground. Relax. Ardhahalasana or the half plow posture. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of abdominal injuries, hernia and lumbosacral pain. Keep hands by the sides of thighs, palms resting on the ground. Inhale. Slowly raise your legs together without bending them at the knees and bring them vertical to the ground. The body from hip to shoulder should be kept straight. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Slowly bring the legs down to the ground without lifting the head. Relax. Pavan Muktasana or the wind freeing posture. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of abdominal injuries, hernia, sciatica or severe back pain. Lie down on the back. Bend both the knees. Exhale. Bring both the knees towards the chest. Inhale. Interlock the fingers and clasp the shin below knees. Exhale. Raise the head till your chin touches the knees. Maintain final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale. Bring the head back to the ground and exhale, legs back to the floor. Relax in supine position. Shavasana or the corpse posture. Lie comfortably on the ground with legs stretched out, hands placed by the sides, palms facing upward. Keep the eyes closed. Consciously relax the whole body. Become aware of natural flow of breath. It will tend to become slow. Remain in the position until you feel refreshed and relaxed. Kapalbhati. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of cardiac conditions, epilepsy, hernia, gastric ulcers and during menstrual cycle. Sit in any comfortable position. Close the eyes and relax the whole body. Inhale deeply through both the nostrils till you start experiencing fullness of the pelvic space and the chest expands. Expel the breath with forceful contractions of the lower abdominal muscles and let the inhalation be passive. Let us begin the first round of Kapalbhati with 20 strokes. Exhale deeply and relax. This is one round of Kapalbhati. Repeat two more rounds with 20 strokes each. Pranayam. Nadi Shodhan Pranayam, or the alternate nostril breathing. Start with sitting in any comfortable posture. Breath should be slow, steady, and controlled. Keep the spine and the head straight with eyes closed. Relax the body with few deep breaths. Keep the left palm on the left knee in Jnana Mudra and right hand should be in Pranayama Mudra with the middle and the index fingers folded like this. Close the right nostril with the thumb and practice exhalation. Now inhale through left nostril. Recognize the touch of air moving through your body as prana. Close the left nostril with the ring and the little fingers and exhale through the right nostril. Now inhale through the right nostril. Close the right nostril with the thumb and exhale through the left nostril. This is one round of Nadi Shodhan Pranayam. Repeat it for four more rounds. Sheetali Pranayam. Caution. People suffering from cough, cold, and tonsillitis should avoid the practice of this pranayam. Sit in any comfortable posture. Place the hand on the knees in Jnana Mudra. Close your eyes. Now, roll up the tongue and shape it as a tube. Inhale maximum through the tongue. Take the tongue inside the mouth and close the mouth. Then slowly exhale through the nostrils, remaining aware of the area used for smelling. This is one round of Sheetali Pranayam. Repeat it for four rounds. Bhramari Pranayam. Sit in any comfortable posture with closed eyes and inhale deeply through the nose. Exhale slowly, making a deep humming sound. Repeat one more round. Practice the Bhramari Pranayam with Shanmukhi Mudra. Repeat one more round. Dhyana. Sitting in any comfortable position, place the hand on the knees in Jnana Mudra. Close your eyes and sit with a slightly upturned face. You need not concentrate. Just maintain a mild focus between the eyebrows and be conscious of your breath. Let them flow freely. Just observe the flow. If possible, let the thoughts dissolve. Thank you.
for us to take sankalp. I commit myself to remain in a balanced state of mind all the time. It is in this state that my development reaches its greatest possibility. I commit to do my duty to the self, family, at work, to society, and to the world, for the promotion of peace, health, and harmony. The yoga practice would end with Shanti Path, or the universal prayer for everyone's peace and prosperity.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu ma kashchit dukha bhag bhavet, ma kashchit दुख भाग भवे. ओम शांति शांति शांति.